Hi guys, welcome to another Inkscape video tutorial in which we are going to learn what is Calligraphy Tool and how we can draw in Inkscape by using Calligraphy Tool. So, of all the tools that Inkscape offers, probably none will remind you more of working with actual ink than the Calligraphy Tool. It lets you draw in a natural manner and alter things like the width and angle of your stroke as you go. So now let's see how it works. Okay, to access the Calligraphy Tool, I am gonna go into the Inkscape, into the toolbox, and here this is the icon. By clicking, I can access the Calligraphy Tool. Or there is another option. I can just press the short key C on my keyboard, and in that way I can access the Calligraphy Tool. Okay, so when you are into the Calligraphy Tool, into the command bar, you can see there are a lot of options. So you can choose the width. Let's go one by one, and then I'm going to explain how does they affect and what are the settings. Okay, so the first one is width. You can change the width of your pen, as you can see here. You can go into the fill and stroke, and then you can choose your color. So if you want to increase the width, then you can increase width by just entering here. You can enter your value, or you can just increase or decrease by using this plus and minus sign, or you can just click here and then you can increase and decrease by using the top arrow and bottom arrow on your keyboard. Okay, so even there is an option to choose the units. You can choose whatever kind of unit do you want from here, and then you can customize your width size of your nib. Okay, then the next thing is, like, as you can see here, the next option, which is pressure sensitive. So you can use this pressure of the input device to alter the width of the pen. So for example, you are drawing on your tablet, and if you are going to draw with the lighter pressure, so it's going to write a thinner line. It's going to draw a thinner line. And if you are going to draw with the high pressure, more pressure, it's going to draw the thicker line. Okay, so next to that is thinning here. As you can see, this varies the width of the path according to the speed that you draw. With the value of, like, let's say 50, if I'm gonna type here, with the value of 50, if I start slow and then speed up, so you can see, like, if I'm gonna draw it speedily, it's gonna reduce my drawing size. So it's gonna made a very thinner. It depends on the speed, how much speed do you want. Right now I did not have a much speed, so that's why it's a bit thicker. But here you can see I just draw it speedily and it just create this line very thin. So in this way, what you can do is, by changing the speed, you can change the size of the draw. Hi guys, sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful and if you are a serious Inkscape learner, then I'm gonna recommend you can go into the description of this video, where you would find my course link, where I have over 7 hours of Inkscape videos. In every video, I explain each and every individual tool with an example as well. Moreover, if you want to collaborate, if you have some kind of projects or assignment and you want to connect, feel free to contact me with my email, which is also given into the description. Thank you. Okay, so I'm gonna put my thinning, let's say, at 0. Because I don't want to change. And then next option is mass. So, like, if I'm gonna set a mass value, for example, let's say 90. So now, like, if I'm gonna draw, so you can see where my cursor is and the drawing line is following my cursor, but it's way far. So in that way, I have more control where exactly I want to stop. So in this way, this is the goal. Or if I'm gonna reduce the size of the mass, let's say 10, so it's gonna be so close to my cursor, as you can see the drawing line. Okay, the next option is angle. So you can have a fixed angle, or you can have an angle which is gonna be changed by your setting. So for example, if I want to change angle right now, for example, if I want to have a 90 angle, so 90 angle means, like, it's gonna show you the angle for your tip of the pen. So for example, this 90 angles mean, like, if I'm gonna draw horizontal line, it's gonna be wide, thicker, and if I'm gonna go to the vertical, it's gonna be thin. So it's 0 angle for vertical, but for horizontal I have a 90 angle. And if I'm gonna choose the 0 angle, So it's the another way. So now the horizontal line is gonna be thin, 0. And if I'm gonna go to the vertical, so it's gonna be 90, it's gonna be a thicker line. So I can fix the angle by using this fixation here, by using this option to tilt the input device to alter the angle of the pen snip. So I can fix it, or I can, what you can do is you can just change it whenever you want. Okay, so the next option is fixation. So fixation means how much Inkscape should consider your angle values. Right now, for example, if I'm gonna go with the 90 fixations, so it means it should consider your angle settings really serious. So that's why you can see the X and Y thickness is totally different, because it's gonna really consider your setting. But if I'm gonna go with the fixation 0, then it means it's not gonna take it serious. So that's why you can see my X and Y values, or the thickness is similar. So it's not gonna consider this so much. Okay, and I'm gonna set 30 then. Okay, the next option is cap. So normally if you are gonna draw a line, as you can see, the edges of the draw is pretty straight, as you can see here. But if I'm gonna go, let's say with the 3, and now I'm gonna draw the line, so you can see it's gonna create a caps ends, and I can go with the more value, let's say 5. So it's gonna be more sharp caps, as you can see here. Okay, so the next tools are trimmer and wiggle. They both are pretty similar. So it's the first option, which is trimmer. It's gonna increase stroke strength and trembling. So in another way, into the simple words, it's gonna give you an effect of shaky hand. So for example, if I'm gonna go and give the trimmer the value of, let's say, 70. And then if I'm gonna draw a line, so if I would go slowly, so you can see it would give the effect of shaky hands. And if I'm gonna draw fast, so it's gonna make it variable, as you can see here. It's not gonna give you a pretty straight line. So I'm gonna go, if I'm gonna go with the 0, so in this way it's normal and the effect is so less. Same in the case of wiggle. Okay, so there are some other options. You can go here into the preset value, so you can choose. There are different options, like you can go with the deep pen. There are different already categorized marker. You can take brush. So you can choose different kind of categories from here. So these are the one which are already available. But if you want to have your own, you can choose your setting, and then if you want to name your own category, then you can just click on that, and then you can made a profile with your name, and it's gonna save the all of the setting whatever you have at that time. And after that, you can just go and set that, and then they are gonna follow your same setting all the time, and then you can draw. So in this way, what you can do is you can play with the calligraphy tool, and you can do multiple things, and you can really feel like you are really drawing with a calligraphic ink pen. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe to support this channel, where you are gonna find a lot of videos and tutorials. And if you are a serious learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video, and you can find my course link, where I have over 5 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every tool in a very detailed video with an example as well. And if you have some projects or assignments or tasks, feel free to write me on my email, which is also given in the description. Thank you.